in the tzara. And then all of your body is doing this dhikr with you, standing and bowing and prostrating on the ground and then sitting. All of that is making your body also join you in the dhikr. Now the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he told us that our body has rights. He told us our body has rights. There are many kinds of rights. Of course you take care of your body, you feed your body. Some of us, we feed our body too much. Like me, I eat too much. But another thing is that the body needs rest. And when you rest your body, this is also good. Even when you sleep, it's good for you. And this is all counting for good deeds because you're giving your body its rights. And a part of giving the body its rights is to let the body make dhikr with you in the salah. When you die and you're in the grave, all of this will come back to you. All of it will come back. If you did good, you have good. If you did bad, serious problem. Serious problem. We know that in the grave there will even be snakes that will be biting the one who was bad. Wow, I don't want that for me. And they said that even it's a poison so bad that if that snake spit that on the earth, nothing could grow there till the day of judgment. Now, when I'm in the grave, I don't need any snakes on me. You know what I mean? So I want to remember Allah now in this life. I want to think about Allah. When you think about Allah and you spend some time in salah, how you feel after your salah? Hassan, how do you feel after you pray? You feel before one way and then after you pray, how do you feel?
Totally better.
Totally better? How about you girls? You feel the same way after you pray?
Yes.
We're talking about dhikr and you're watching Tell Us About Islam. We're going to be right back after this break, so don't you go away. You stay right there. We'll be back with more. Tell Us About Islam.
Islam is a way of life.
Welcome back to this episode of Tell Us About Islam. We've been talking about a word in Arabic, dhikr, also pronounced zikr, and we found out in the first part of our program that it means to keep something in remembrance, to remember something in your mind, but also to hold it in your heart as well. Now, we didn't mention this before, but I'll mention it now. After we pray, after we've done our salah, our dhikr isn't over, is it? There's something called taslim, and that's when we say salam. To the right, salam alaikum. To the left, salam alaikum, like this in our prayer, right? When we do that, the prayer is over, but that's only part of it. The salah part is finished. But there's another part called dhikr, and we begin immediately. We say, as soon as we salam like that, astaghfirullah. 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 What does that mean? Allah, forgive me. Because Allah is al-ghafur. And we're saying, astaghfirullah. We want Allah's forgiveness. We want Him to forgive us. Now, we just prayed. Why would we say, forgive me? I mean, we didn't steal anything. We didn't hurt anybody. Hopefully in your prayer you didn't step on somebody's foot. So why I'm saying astaghfirullah? Because Prophet Muhammad said that the best thing you can say, the best saying is la ilaha illallah, and the best dua is astaghfirullah. And he used to say astaghfirullah after every prayer. And so he also told us that after every prayer, every single prayer like Dhuhr and Asr and Maghrib and Isha and Fajr, all the prayers you have to pray, that as soon as you finish, the next thing you ask Allah, He's going to give it to you. He will give it to you because you did what you're supposed to do. Like a paycheck. He's going to give you a paycheck. This is why I always tell the brothers and the sisters, that when you get through praying, don't jump up and run away. Don't go play with a cell phone. Don't get on the internet. Don't go running down the street. Don't go talking to your friends. Stay where you are. Because the next thing that you ask Allah for, He'll give it to you. But if you run away and forget, you didn't get your paycheck. That doesn't make too much sense, does it? If you work hard, don't you like to get paid? If you go to school and you get good grades, don't you like to get your report card? Yeah, you worked hard, you want it? Of course. And in the same way, after you pray, after you do your salah, stay where you are and say, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Then after that, la ilaha illallah. And after that, you say, Allahumma, antis salam, wa minkas salam. You know the rest of it? Dhul jalali wal ikram. You know it? It says, oh Allah, from you is the peace. Because Allah is the peace. You, anta, antis salam, you're the peace. Wa minka, from you, comes the peace. So this is also important. Allahumma, antis salam, wa minkas salam. And He is the sovereign over everything. Allah is the owner and controller of the universe. This is more or less the meaning. And sometimes the Arabic things don't really translate to English, but we try to get the idea behind it. This is something very good for us to say because it reminds us that really if we want peace, we have to get it from Allah. And we know that Allah is the peace. He is As-Salam. And to have this peace in our heart by remembering Allah is the goal of every person. Because when it's all over with, when your life is finished and you're gone from here, then in the next life, if you were good, if you obeyed Allah's rules the best you could, you will find real peace. The best peace of all is only in the Jannah with Allah. And that's the real goal of every Muslim. The most important goal for every Muslim of this life is to find the peace in the next life, to be close to Allah, to be close to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, close to Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, close to Prophet Abraham and Prophet Adam,